Welcome to my channel Creative Art. I am Nilima and today we are going to paint this beautiful relief painting. Relief painting is something you build layers on layers. So in this painting I have built up 4 layers and this is how beautiful it looks. Relief paintings are unique and difficult to find one, so why not make one for yourself? Friends, as this is one of your most requested videos, so please to watch the whole video to make it yourself and do subscribe my channel friends for more creative techniques of painting, home decors and crazy DIYs. All the materials required to make this beautiful relief painting are mentioned in the description box below with their links from where you can also buy them. And friends, for creating relief, we are going to need this kind of coat, which is a mixture of Arabic gum and marble powder. If you don't get Arabic gum, you can also use Fevicol. And to know all the details how I have made this cone, please to watch my previous video, Materials for Persian Art and Relief Painting. I'll mention the link in the description box below. So let's start now friends. Friends, this is the reference I'm going to use for my painting. If you're good in drawing, you can directly make it on canvas. And friends, we are going to use a hard canvas board, which will save a lot of time of preparing the base, because canvas boards like this can be directly used for Persian art or relief painting. For more perfection in my painting, I'm going to trace this design on my base. So I will place the carbon paper exactly where I want to trace the design, secure it using tape, and then exactly place the design where I want to trace it. Okay, it perfectly fits there. Then using tape, I'll secure the reference with the base in this way. And then using a pen, go all over the design in this way, so that there will be an imprint of this design on your canvas. So friends, I'm going to complete it in the same way and then I will show you how it looks, okay? Now friends, my tracing part is finally completed. Let me remove it for you and show you. This is how it has come up. Now we're going to start the designing part, and for that I'll cut the cone in the size I want. Okay, and check. Yes, this is perfect. Okay, now I'm going to start the designing part using my cone. We have to simply go all over the design in this way. Apply an even pressure on the cone. Our first step will be to make only the design. So using cone, I will go all over the design and make it exactly how it is. Okay friends, so in the same way, I'm going to complete the whole designing part and then I will show you how to do the next step. Okay, so friends, this is how it looks when the whole lining part is completed. Now our second step is filling the design, but before that you also have to decide which part you want to make your first layer, then second and third. For example, I want to lift up all the 3 flowers, so I'll be filling up all the 3 flowers. Okay, this is the first leaf filled up. This is going to be the bottom layer, so I'm not going to fill up this leaf. And then I'm also going to fill up this third petal. After filling the petals, use a single drop of water in your fingers and then tap the layer so that your layer will be smooth. Do not use a lot quantity of water because that can spoil your painting. Okay. So in this way, I'm going to fill up only the first layer and then I will show you how does it looks, okay? Okay, then use a little bit of water in your fingers and then just smooth the level. So friends, in the same way, I'm going to do the first layer and then I will show you how does it looks, okay? So friends, this is how our relief work looks when we have done one layer of it. Now I'm going to do the second layer. So first of all, I'll do the designing. Now we will start the designing part of the second layer. So we have to go through the same lining and the designing we did in the first layer. We are making it above one level, okay? We will do the same with the side designs also. Okay, now the designing of second layer is completed, so I'm going to do the filling part of the second layer. There's a little bit of water in your fingers and smooth the surface. Use water again and level this. Okay, so now I have completed the filling part of second layer. I let it get dry and then finally I'll do the designing part of third layer. So now friends, my second layer is also completely dried up. So I'll do the final designing part. So now friends, it is finally completed, so I will let this final part get dry. Now I'm thinking to create one more layer in few curves of this flower. So I'll do the filling. Now friends, I'll let it get dry, do the final designing only 1, 2, 3 year and then I will show you how does it looks. Okay friends, now my relief work is finally completed and this is how it looks. You can see all the detailings I have done and we have finally completed making one layer. This is the first layer, second, third layer and this one is the final fourth layer. We have made four layers in this flower and on the leaves I have just created two layers and on these leaves as you can see we have created 1, 2, 3, 4 layers. Okay friends, after completing the relief part we are going to start the coloring part, and for coloring a relief painting or a Persian art it is generally advised to use oil colors, but this time friends I'm going to use Camel Artist acrylic colors. I hope you know the basic difference between both the mediums. I personally like to use this medium for my paintings because acrylic colors are permanent, they dry up quick and they also give a very bright look as compared to the oil colors. So for this painting friends, I'm going to use acrylic colors. You can also use the other medium which is oil color. It completely depends on your comfort. So let's start now friends. While painting, you have to mix just a little bit of water each time with the color while painting. First of all, I'm going to use a brown color and color the background part using it. Now after coloring the base as brown, I'm going to color inner base using golden color. You can also use a pale pink or a peach color. So in the same way, I'm going to complete the golden coloring part first. After coloring the center base as golden color, this is how it looks. It is complete contrast with the brown, so it looks much brighter and better. So now friends, we are going to start coloring the leaves and the background leaves also. And for that, I'm going to use a dark green color. I'm going to place the dark green color on the bottom leaves and a light green color on the top so that it may give a natural look to the design. First of all, you have to color on the clay in this way and then using a cloth, wipe it in the downwards direction. You can see some of the paint has been carried forward by this cloth and you can clearly see the clay design, which in my way looks beautiful. In the same way, I'll color this leaf also. First, you have to color the leaf and then wipe it out.
I'm giving the top leaves as a bit light green color and then wipe out the color. So in the same way, I'm going to color all the leaves and then wipe it using a cloth. The same type of light color shading I want to do on the top leaves. And now we're going to do the dark colors. Now I'm going to use a dark green color. Half part I'll do it with dark green. And for the rest half I'm going to use light green. Okay, then wipe it off using a cloth. Now after coloring the leaves, I'm going to start coloring the flower, and for that, first of all, I'm going to use a dark blue color and then use a light blue color. I'm going to give a shading, okay? Do a little bit of shading if you're comfortable with it. And then wipe out the top of the color in this way so that you get a clear shading from light towards dark. I'll show you once again. Using a light blue and then just a hint of dark blue on this edge, and then wipe the top using a cloth. Take just a little bit of white and shade the tip of the flower petal using it, and take a little bit of dark blue and shade this part. Then the top can be easily wiped off so that the clay work can be seen easily. Use a little bit of white on the top. Then using dark blue, create a little bit of shading and bring it upwards. So this is the way you have to color a flower. Now, after completing the flower, I'm going to color these two center parts using orange color. I'm going to use a little bit of dark red color to give this part also shading. Okay, so in the same way, friends, we have to color all the flowers. Take a little bit of dark blue. I'm using white color to do the highlights. Now, I'll show you to paint this cherry blossoms. So first of all, I'm going to use a light pink color and fill up the whole flower. Then in the same brush, I'm going to take a little bit of dark pink color and just make that in center like this. Wipe my brush, then spread it so that there must be a shading in this flower. Okay, we got the shading finally. Take some more paint. Perfect as we want. Okay, so the same we have to do with all the three flowers. Place light pink first. Then take a little bit of dark pink to the shading part. Finally, use white to do the border clay part. It will highlight the border clay. So in the same way, we have to color all the cherry blossoms. Now, I'm going to color these tiny branches using a bronze color. Now I'm using blue color to color the flower buds which are inside the golden region, and I have used orange color to color the flower buds which are on the brown background. Now we are going to color the center part of the flower, which is this, and for that I'm using orange color. Now I'm going to use just a little bit of bronze on this tip and create a slight shading. So now it is finally completed, so I will let it get dry. So friends, this is how our relief painting looks when it is finally completed and dried up. So now friends, we are going to varnish it, and for that I'm going to use Liquitex professional high gloss varnish, and I'm going to give two coatings of this varnish. For that, first of all, pour the varnish in your palette, and then using a clean flat brush, give a very thin layer all over your painting. The layer should be thin and there should be no bubbles while varnishing. You can also use a spray varnish if you like to, but always remember to give two coatings. Okay, now friends, our first layer is completed, so I will let this part get dry and then repeat the same step once more and then show you how does it looks. Okay, so friends, now my second layer of varnishing is also completed and it's dried up. You can clearly see the gloss it has given to my painting is really extraordinary. The Liquitex varnish is a bit costly as compared to other varnishes, but its performance is really worth it. On all my special paintings like this, I use the Liquitex professional varnish to leave this kind of finishing touch. So let's frame it now. This is how beautiful my relief painting has come up when I have framed it using a golden and bronze border, and on the support I have also add one stripe of golden and bronze. You can see, which completely makes the painting look perfect. And friends, if you can observe the gloss on the painting, which is because of the varnish, it really makes my painting looks flawless and gives such a beautiful finishing. It is really very important to frame your relief paintings or Persian art because your painting is completely made of clay and these are really very difficult to find. So friends, if you're making one for yourself, please to frame your painting as this is going to last forever and you can pass it on and on. So friends, please to tell me in the comments below how did you find this video, and if you did like this video friends, please to like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.